Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. In a world of e-cars, e-bikes, and even e-scooters, we thought we would deep dive into something that makes them all run, the battery. So let's go to our friends at Aalen University, see what we can find out. Hey, Andreas.
Hi, Jay.
Good to see you. Okay, so to begin our journey here, we came back to the Materials Research Institute at Aalen University, and Andreas is here to guide us on our journey. Andreas, thank you for coming. Thanks for your time and taking us through your department.
Thank you. Yes, today we are gonna have a closer look into lithium-ion batteries.
Wow.
So that's one of our main topics here at the Materials Research Institute. So there are different questions we are concerning about talking lithium-ion batteries. One of it is, how can we improve the material that is inside to make them last longer and to make our car go longer with those batteries? Another part is optimizing the production processes, because they have a huge influence on the internal microstructure and on the performance of the battery as well. And then we are also looking for like quality assessment tools. So how can we predict the quality of a battery cell during the production? And even if we buy it from the shelf,
sure,
how do we know what is a good battery?
Right, right, how to tell. So there's different techniques in being able to either A, make the batteries go longer, extend the life physically, or just have a better battery, right?
Yes, there are a lot of opportunities or a lot of possibilities to improve those batteries. And so we are using a whole bunch of technologies to get further information about the microstructure, about the alignment and assembly process of the battery, to see if everything is in the right place, and also if every safety devices are in place and are working properly.
Sure, sure. Okay, so we actually have to, they all look the same from the outside, right? So we actually have to dive inside. How do we start doing that?
Yes, we start with a computer tomography scan,
okay,
of this cell, so we can have a deeper look inside.
Okay.
So you want to have a look inside?
Can we go inside there?
Of course.
All right, let's do it. Awesome. Okay, Andreas, other than being super, super cool, what's going on in here?
So here we have a CT data set, and there we can look inside the battery without destroying it. And then we can check if the battery is assembled the right way. Are there any safety margins too slow or too small? Is there any welding voids inside it, or is the whole geometry in the right way?
Okay, so we're able to just really see inside because of the CT scan that you were talking about earlier.
Yes.
We're able to see inside, and yeah, we can definitely see structures. I can see what's going on in there. Now, is this data good enough for us to get all the way in there and like see voids and things like that? I know we can do that sometimes with CT data.
We don't can see really the small details like single particles in the coatings, but we can see like the jelly roll in itself. We can see the end of the sheets and if they are aligned right. But if we have to look deeper, we need different technologies.
What's that different technology?
We have to open the cell and use microscopy to look into it.
Open the cell? When you say open the cell, what do you mean?
Really, literally open it, so don't do this at home.
Okay.
So we have to go to a different lab and do it.
We have to cut it open?
Way. Yes.
All right. I suggest we save that for another vlog, but is that cool if we do that?
Sure.
And let's go look at that process. Cool. So I guess for now, I will just continue to mess around with this VR data and stay safe, stay healthy. We'll see you next Thursday.